daddy works on the railway. In 1842, from Hartlepool, I moved to Crewe, found myself a job to do.
Hello, I messed up again, the audio's rubbish, but I'll do a voiceover. So I've got a block of wood, it's a bit of scrap I had knocking around, and I'm drilling a 12mm hole through the middle, all the way through. Rough shaping it into sort of a ball shape. None of the ones I made would roll very well, but they don't need to. Now I'm hollowing it out. I'm not too fussy about the hollowing. All I want to do is reduce the weight. If I get the weight down to a sensible size, then we're all good. Put the next one on, do the same stages. And this time I'll be a bit better and put some lines on it and show you how I go about getting somewhere near a circle. It'll go faster because it's the same cuts as you've just seen, so let's do double the speed. I'm only working one end really, the other end I will do shortly with a jam chuck. I'm just sort of roughing out a bit. And then get the weight out. Now this is actually laminated bits of pine, there's nothing special about this wood at all. Not the sort of thing I'd normally cut, but I'm going to paint them, so who cares. Switch from the bent one to the straight one to get further into the back, and then repeat it all again on the third one. Oh, so you can see I didn't measure anything there, I'm just guessing. And I've got to use this one neck, or the bent one, on this. But it doesn't matter. 12mm hole. Simon Hope mini hollow gives you plenty of space. This is my jam chuck. We had a bit of scrap wood and as a 12mm post in the middle, so it fits my holes and I can put my piece of wood on there either way around. Get it all up nice and tight. Then we're back to speed times one now, because I'll just show you how I do this bit. Cutting towards the headstock to get rid of the bulk of the mask, because I am on a jam chuck and it needs to be a little bit gently treated. And then just take it into a curve. Get Don't worry about any marks and lines because they sand away pretty quick, especially with pine. Third one on, back at the high speed. You see, these things don't take long to make. Okay, this is how I make my separation cones, I suppose they're called. There's a 10mm drill bit. Hole size doesn't have to be accurate, so long as it goes over the dowel. A bit of a clear every now and then. Wood is nothing special, it's the end of an old broom handle that's just used for another job. But anything will do. That's drilled to the end of the fruit. I can always cut a few in and drill some more. Then my piece of wood. So I'm going to be cutting down towards piece of metal. Well, remember, I just drilled a 10mm hole through this, so middle isn't in the middle. Separate them like that, and the bit of surface they're touching on is going to be covered with a finial. But that allows me to finish multiple pieces at one go. Annoying me, I forgot to press, well, unpressure at pause. So I missed this bit, which I wanted to show you. Hey-oh. The whole point of this jig is I can do three in one go. The drying time that is actually longer than the working time by quite a long way, is split by three or four or however many you make. And as when I'm lacquering and painting, I'm only turning by hand or 100 or so RPM on the lathe. It doesn't take a lot of work to make it work. What's not in shot should be, I've got a piece of tube over the end of the dowel up against the tailstock live centre. So that's what holds it all together. I've just gone for a cup of coffee, come back, drying time has happened. So we get to lacquering. And again, the more coats of lacquer you use, you split that by three in this case, So it's a lot of time saved. The jig does get shown later in the video, so you'll get another look at it. But it is literally a piece of towel, the cones that you saw me cutting, and a piece of tube. Okay, so I like to drill holes. If I'm going to have a hole in my piece, I like to drill it where it's still got a flat piece on it, because I can use my drill press, get the hole in there, and then cut around it. I find it quicker. As you can see, I've got four pieces ready. Put them out of reach at the moment. And gonna make them round. Now, in theory, I could pile that off, put that into my dome jaws, and finish the top with that. However, my dome jaws are in use at the moment. But that's kind of where we're going. And so you've got a hole for a ribbon to attach it to a tree. That's a 5mm hole. I tend to like bigger holes for this sort of thing because people like to use ribbons. Let's get on with it. Touch of maple syrup. Yeah, a bit of tree grit. Hampshire Sheen High Gloss. I like Hampshire Sheen High Gloss a lot. It's a mix of carnauba, which gives a high shine, and microcrystalline, which gives good protection. So it's a cocktail wax, which means the alcohol content is somewhere between the two. The alcohol content that matters in wax is its melting point. Don't like beeswax because it melts way too low and you end up with a soft wax which collects dust and fingerprints for a pastime. And obviously I'd need to finish sand, although it's done with a skew, so there's not a lot to do, and polish this top end. We'll come back to that. Give it a test spin. So it's all clear. Thank you, then. So if you notice that cut, I'm actually undercutting quite steeply here. That allows for groove space and also covers up poor cutting. So I've got room there to glue that on. We glue it. Similar design to the last one, but shorter. And let's part that off. I'll do that in a minute.
Now, if you don't want to use a spindle roughing gouge, you don't have to. So you can take corners off just as well. Christmas tree one. So four top finials done. Okay, now for the bottom finials. A while back, I was cutting what are they called, stair spindle, and I cut it upside down, or cut one of them upside down, and it's been sat on the floor laughing at me ever since. So it's now been chopped up, and we'll make some bottom finials out of that. Thank you. Right, he's just being silly. I don't recommend this to anybody. Let's go out a little bit. Yeah, don't recommend this to anybody. Let's see if we can cut a finial with an inch and a quarter spindle rough and gouge. Okay, there's no way I'm going to be able to do the tenon with a spindle rough and gouge. So I will cheat for that bit. Not the prettiest one ever, but yeah. And with spindle rough and gouge. So that sounded to 400 because I'm doing something different. Brushing on some gold calligraphy ink, Winsor & Newton. I'll pause you, let that dry, go get a coffee. See you in a bit.
Well, that's the job done. With the aid of a couple of tools. This one is just a jam chuck. And this one, which allows me to do multiple lacquerings, colourings, whatever, at the same time, which are all good stuff. And there's four Christmas baubles. Snowman, pointy thing, funny shape, Christmas tree, sort of, with a gold wax on this one, gold ink on this one with lacquer, gold ink on this one, put on without sanding sealer and then lacquered. Just a straightforward wax on this one. And this one's gold ink again, but this was put on after sanding sealer just to make a difference. This one was also cut with a spindle roughing gouge, 1¼ inch, apart from the tenon and a few details at the top end. Everything else was done. Not that I'd recommend that, that isn't sensible. But there you go. As I said at the beginning, this video in memory of Lola, so a cat who passed away last week. Excuse me. Been with us for a few years, 8 years in total. She was a rescue cat, and we're going to miss her. Anyhow, happy Christmas everyone. It's the hashtag bauble, hashtag bauble week by Steve SK Crafts. Hopefully lots of you will get involved in that and get your pictures off to Steve by Friday this week so that he can put them together as a video. Thanks for watching. Please remember to put the thumbs up, subscribe and all the usual stuff, and see you on the next one.